The Saiga antelope, with its distinctive bulbous nose, is a fascinating animal, known for their incredible migrations. Saigas live in some of the harshest climates on Earth. They have many unique adaptations that have allowed them to survive since the beginning of the last ice age. As usual, a document with the sources for the images used, along with research papers I found useful, will be included in the description of this video. Just recently, I released a video about the four-horned antelope. Like the Saiga, it is also a ruminant in the family Bovidae. I have talked about these groups recently and I will not repeat myself here. Please watch that video for more information on the unique digestion of ruminants and the differences in horn structures between bovids and other ruminants. Bovidae has 10 subfamilies, and the Saiga is in a different one to the four-horned antelope. The four-horned antelope is one of the many species in the first subfamily, Bovinae. This also includes the cattle-like ruminants such as buffalo and bison, and antelopes like the Niala and Kudu. Next are two very small subfamilies. The first is Ipiserotinae, which only has one species, the impala. The other is Nesotragenae, with two species of dwarf antelope. The next clade has Antilopinae, sometimes known as the true antelopes. This is the subfamily that includes the Saiga, as well as gazelles, springbok, and dikdiks, among others. Cephalophinae contains 22 species of dikas. There is some disagreement as to whether these are a subfamily or a tribe within the Antilopinae. Most agree that they are in their own subfamily. The last subfamily in this clade is Oreotragenae, which only has one species, the clipspringer. This is unusual as one of the very few nocturnal bovids. The subfamily of Reducinae has 9 species of antelope, all known for living in marshes or floodplains. These include the reedbucks and waterbucks. Next is Caprinae, which includes the goats, sheep, ibexes, and their relatives. This is a large group, including several domesticated species and their closest wild relatives. Most of them do well at high altitudes. Alcelaphinae has several large antelopes, including wildebeests, hartebeests, and topi. The exact number of species here is debated, with some scientists suggesting that there are only a few species with many subspecies. Others disagree, elevating some subspecies to the status of a separate species. Finally, the last subfamily is Hippotragenae, which includes the sable antelopes and oryxes. They are known for their larger, more horse-like proportions, which is where the subfamily name comes from, with hippo being Greek for horse. So, the Saiga is in the subfamily Antilopinae. Antilopinae are found throughout Africa and Asia. Most of them have relatively long necks and small pointed snouts. The subfamily is divided into 3 tribes. The largest is Antilopinae, which includes the gazelles, springbok, blackbuck, gerenuk, and dibbertag. Most species have some form of facial markings and often live in large and sometimes mixed species herds. Most of them can also run extremely fast, up to 80 km per hour or 50 miles per hour, and are very agile, able to jump high and turn sharply. The next tribe is Nesotragenae. This is smaller than Antilopinae, only including dikdiks, royal antelope, bira, arebi, steenbok, and grisbok, for about 10 species in total. These are small antelopes, even including the smallest antelope in the world. The last tribe is Saigeni, and this only contains a single species, the Saiga. The history of this is a little more complicated, as it was once believed that the Saiga was most closely related to the Tibetan antelope, Pantelops hodgsonii, due to similar morphological characteristics. Genetic analysis has proven this to be incorrect, and their similarities are the result of convergent evolution. The Tibetan antelope has been moved into the subfamily Caprinae, as it is more closely related to goats and sheep than it is to the Saiga. Now that we understand the phylogeny a little better, let's focus on the main subject of today's video. Usually known simply as the Saiga, Saiga tatarica is also called the Saiga antelope. It is highly unusual among living species for the common name to be the same as the genus name. This is common with dinosaurs. I mean, do you know the species name of Triceratops? There are 2 species, if you are curious, but Triceratops horridus is the one most people are familiar with. However, among living species, this is rare, although there are some exceptions, such as the Saiga. The name Saiga derives from Russian, where it is used to refer to chamois fabric, a soft, absorbent material. As a species, the Saiga has been around for a very long time. Fossils of them date back to 100,000 years ago, near the start of the last ice age. This means that they coexisted alongside well-known ice age giants, such as the woolly mammoth, woolly rhinoceros, and dire wolf. Several extinct species of Saiga have been identified, but more recent research suggests that these are regional variants and not separate species. Saiga fossils are very similar to modern Saiga, suggesting that their morphology has not changed much over this large time frame. Their range has drastically reduced since prehistoric times. At their peak, Saigas could be found from Alaska and probably Canada, through Siberia and all the way to modern-day France and England. Even a few hundred years ago, they were much more widespread, being found from China to southeastern Europe. Today, they are only found in Central Asia, with their largest populations in Kazakhstan. They can also be found in parts of Russia, Mongolia, and Uzbekistan. There are two subspecies. The main one is the Russian Saiga, found throughout most of their range, while the Mongolian population is considered a different subspecies. Saigas inhabit dry grasslands and semi-arid deserts, preferring open plains with only low-growing vegetation. This provides good visibility for spotting predators and does not impede their ability to run. They may leave their preferred habitat to shelter from strong winds, however. Saigas can be found from near sea level up to 1600 metres or 5000 feet above sea level. During the Ice Age, Saigas inhabited the Mammoth Steppe, a massive biome covering most of Eurasia with similar habitat, indicating their habitat preferences are not believed to have changed over millennia. Saigas stand up to 81 centimetres or 32 inches tall at the shoulder and can weigh up to 69 kilograms or 152 pounds. Their most notable feature is their nose. The nostrils are close together, but far more noticeable is its length. The nose is long, swollen, and droops down from their muzzle. This unusual appearance is actually an important adaptation. This nose helps the Saiga survive both the hot summer and freezing winter. It filters dust from the air, preventing the animal from inhaling it. This is crucial in their dry habitats, especially when large herds kick up dust while moving. The nose may also clean and purify the air before it reaches the lungs. In summer, the nose cools the blood thanks to its many blood vessels. In winter, it has the opposite function, warming the cold air before it enters the body. This is vital in regions like Mongolia, where winter temperatures average between negative 10 to negative 30 degrees Celsius or 14 to 22 Fahrenheit. This adaptation is necessary to survive in such a harsh climate, which is capable of killing most warm-blooded animals. The nose also plays a role in communication. Male Saiga roar during the mating season, and their nose helps to create these vocalizations. These calls advertise the animal's size and health to prospective mates. Saiga have different coats for summer and winter. In summer, their coat is thinner and buff-colored. In winter, this coat becomes much thicker and whiter. Males have horns with pronounced rings that can grow up to 38 centimeters or 15 inches long. However, this varies between subspecies, with Mongolian Saiga horns growing only up to 22 centimeters or 8.7 inches long. Saigas form large herds as they graze across grasslands. These herds typically consist of females and their young, led by a dominant male. During the breeding season, the male maintains a harem of females which he defends from other males. These fights are intense, with males locking horns and pushing against each other to overpower their opponent. Weaker males may be deterred by the display of horns alone. Males also extend their noses, which is thought to be another display of aggression and dominance. After mating, females are pregnant for 4.5 to 5 months before giving birth. They usually have twins, although single calves are not uncommon. Newborns are hidden in tall grass to protect them from predators, but within a week they start joining the herd. Calves mature rapidly, with females becoming sexually mature at around 7 months old. Males take about 2 years to mature, likely due to the need to build their strength to challenge older males. Outside of the breeding season, Saiga do not have fixed territories. Instead, they are highly migratory, with some of the longest migrations of any terrestrial animal. They can migrate several hundred to over 1,000 kilometers, driven by the need to find suitable grasslands. In the spring, Saigas move north to more abundant northern grasslands, while in winter they move south to avoid freezing conditions. This migratory pattern ensures that the Saiga have access to the best resources year-round. Saiga are always vigilant for predators. They have keen hearing and smell to detect threats and can run up to 80 kilometers per hour or 50 miles per hour to escape. This top speed puts them among the fastest terrestrial animals, comparable to many other antelopes, although not quite as fast as the cheetah or pronghorn. The Saiga is now listed as near threatened by the IUCN, a significant improvement from its earlier rating of critically endangered in 2023. However, conserving the Saiga remains challenging due to numerous threats and mass mortality events. As recently as the 2010s, 95% of all Saiga were estimated to have died within 15 years, culminating in May 2015, when over 200,000 Saiga died within a 3-week span. Such large-scale deaths can cause the bottleneck effect, where significant genetic diversity is lost. This can be problematic, as the remaining population may be more susceptible to being wiped out, even after their numbers recover. For example, in a healthy population, some individuals will likely have genetics that provide better resistance to diseases, ensuring the species' survival during outbreaks. However, if those disease-resistant genes are lost due to a bottleneck, the entire species is at risk of extinction from a disease they no longer have resistance to. In the case of the Saiga, they have undergone many of these bottlenecks, with the one in the 2010s being only the most recent. So, what has caused these mass mortality events? The one in the 2010s was caused by passerolysis, a bacterial infection in lungs and intestines. The reason it became problematic at that time is still not understood. Saiga are susceptible to a wide array of diseases, including foot and mouth, brucellosis, and septicemia. This susceptibility is compounded by the large herds they live in, which facilitates the spread of diseases and creates these mass mortality events. Diseases are not the only threat. Hunting by humans caused a major decline in Saiga numbers in the early 1900s. When Saiga numbers were at their lowest in the 1920s, this led to the extinction of the Mongolian Saiga gadfly, an insect reliant on Saigas for its life cycle. Hunting was primarily for their horns, used in traditional Chinese medicine. Even today, their horns are in high demand. A 2019 study found that 19% of Chinese Singaporeans in Singapore regularly use traditional medicines containing Saiga horns. The value of their horns is considered equal to that of rhinoceros horns, and is often seen as an acceptable substitute in traditional Chinese medicine. The 1920s saw their numbers plummet to the lowest recorded. After recovering from this, the Saiga population crashed again due to increased hunting pressure following the fall of the USSR in the 1980s and 1990s. They are hunted not only for their horns either, but also their meat and hides. In Kazakhstan alone, between 1955 and 1989, over 5 million Saiga were killed for their meat, yielding an estimated 87,000 tons of meat. Other threats to the Saiga are related to climate change and habitat loss. They face severe droughts in summer and prolonged snowfall in winter, both of which significantly impact Saiga populations. Droughts make water scarce and kill vegetation, while prolonged snowfall restricts their access to vegetation. These harsh conditions can kill up to 50% of Saiga. While the populations only take 2 to 3 years to recover, multiple harsh weather conditions in successive years are a major concern. The impact of climate change on these weather effects is still poorly understood, but is likely severe. Habitat loss is another major concern. Fires during droughts have destroyed large swaths of the steppes. Much of their territory has been overgrazed by domestic livestock or converted into farmland. This not only destroys their habitat, but also increases the risk of disease transmission from livestock, a threat that will become more prominent as they come into closer contact. Despite these threats and mass die-offs, it is surprising that Saigas are still around today. Their main advantage is their ability to recover numbers quickly, despite facing staggering losses in some years. Despite the deaths in the 2010s, the global population was estimated to be over 1.3 million in 2022. 98% of these are in Kazakhstan, with only about 20,000 in Mongolia and Russia. Various measures have been enacted to protect Saigas. Kazakhstan initiated a ban on hunting in 1999 and harshly dealt with poaching. This ban was reaffirmed in 2011. Recently, there have been suggestions to lift the ban, as the million Saigas are reaching plague levels for farmers. It has also been suggested that the government might undertake culls to control the population without allowing unrestricted hunting that could cause another population crash. As far as I can tell, none of these actions have been undertaken yet, but the government is considering them. Aside from Kazakhstan's laws, there are also international protections for saigas. The Convention for the International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, more commonly known as CITES, has listed them in Appendix 2 to restrict their international trade. CITES has worked closely with the Convention on the Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals, or CMS, leading workshops to draft work programs to protect saigas, and they have various joint programs focusing on them. The Mongolian government has also taken steps to protect the saiga, passing legislation to outlaw hunting in 1953. Unfortunately, enforcing this decree is problematic, so illegal poaching remains a large threat to the Mongolian population. In addition to outright bans on hunting, saigas are found in many protected areas throughout their range. New protected areas have been designated as recently as 2021 and 2022, primarily for saiga protection. These protected areas are in Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and Mongolia. The Russian population is harder to protect due to geopolitical isolation, making it impossible for international funding to help that population. Saigas are difficult to keep in captivity, but several small breeding centres and facilities maintain their wild populations with captive bred stock. The largest of these are in Kazakhstan and, surprisingly, Ukraine. Saigas have been extirpated in Ukraine since the 1700s. Despite this, the Askania Nova Biosphere Reserve in Ukraine has maintained a population of around 700 semi-domestic saiga, growing significantly from the 72 they had in the 1970s. Many organisations are working towards the recovery of saigas. One of the largest is the Saiga Conservation Alliance, which does a lot of work restoring their habitat and protecting them. They spearhead the Resurrection Island Project, a large-scale restoration project near the Aral Sea on the Uzbekistan-Kazakhstan border. This area used to be an island, but the Aral Sea has shrunk to less than 10% of its former size, so Resurrection Island is now connected to the mainland. However, the former lake bed is a toxic salt desert where little grows. Afforestation efforts are underway, and it is hoped that this will halt or reverse the desertification in the area. The creation of this habitat corridor will also help to ensure saiga and other animals can safely migrate and move through Resurrection Island. I will include a link to the Saiga Conservation Alliance website in the description of this video, as it has a lot of interesting information on this subject for anyone interested. I hope you enjoyed this video. Saiga are fascinating animals that have been around for the last 100,000 years. They have many adaptations that have allowed them to survive for so long in one of the harshest climates on Earth. Despite the recent recovery of their numbers, saigas are still in severe danger due to the many mass mortality events they have experienced. Thank you for listening, and feel free to suggest another group of animals you want to see me cover in the comments.